And truly crispy, Archer Grill.
Truly crispy. It. And, you know, this is going to make your whole meal, but it's also going to make snacks for throughout the week. It's going to make your sides. It's great at roasting vegetables using that bake feature. And everything is going to be super crispy outside. We crave texture. That's why a lot of meals you'll see have, like, different textures throughout. That crispiness with that, like, ooey, mushy, potato middle that we all love, that's what we love to eat.
Oh, it's so nice, so good. Okay, guys, I'm actually on Facebook Live. We're simulcasting, so if you want to ask Kenzie a question, you sure can.
Yeah.
Marilyn says, wow, it looks delicious. Just got here, can't wait to see more meals. This is the best price anywhere. Yes, Teresa, she got it. We have the best deal anywhere, 100%, I can guarantee it. This is your place to buy this Ninja as well. And again, if you want to ask her a question, certainly do. Mm-hmm. Here's the miracle behind it. No one's ever done this before. It's so revolutionary. It's the best, the very best of air frying. And mm-hmm. I've sold a lot of air fryers. And I will tell you, the results on this one were completely, completely substantially different than my other air fryers I've used. Yeah, I mean, this is really many steps above a traditional air fryer. Take what we love about pressure cooking and then go above that many steps. And that is the magic behind one. You don't need a million appliances anymore. You need the Ninja. And I think that's probably the reason people have it's become that buzz.
Exactly.
Because they realize, I don't need 20 different appliances. I need just one to do searing and to do steaming and to cook rice and to cook pasta, makes casseroles. I can do my air frying. It just goes on and it's all in one really convenient unit. Yeah, even if it's as simple as making a piece of non-guilt fried chicken. There it is. Doesn't that look good?
I like the name of it.
It was delicious too.
I'm so
I gotta tell you. It was, and I love the rack.
And you use the rack for it. So this is the rack that you were talking about before that comes with the unit. It can be used two different ways. So you can use it in the steam position or the lower position, and then you flip that upside down, and that's what you're going to use to broil or to do things like your chicken. Mm-hmm. And here I'm going to build what I like to call a 360 meal, and that means that the 360 degrees of your plate are going to have three different textures. So if you're making rice and then chicken and then asparagus, that's going to be three different textures. Here what I'm doing is actually a steak dinner. So I've got some potatoes, some raw potatoes in the pot, and I'm going to go ahead and just add in my rack right on top of those potatoes. We've got the water in there as well. Now, this is something you've probably never seen before. When you come home from a long day, what's the first place you look for dinner? The freezer?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But then you're like, wait, I didn't defrost anything. How am I supposed
like,
to
oh,
cook
shoot.
This? So what I'm going to do is actually make a steak dinner from frozen steaks. This is rock hard frozen steak. And we're going to add
really
those two steaks right on top of that rack. Right there.
Okay, so you have the potatoes down below.
So we've got the potatoes down below with our water, and you're gonna need to use about half a cup of water or chicken stock or wine anytime you're pressure cooking, and that's gonna allow it to build the steam that actually cooks the food.
Okay.
So then we're gonna add our pressure cooking lid. Now, once we add the pressure cooking lid, the bottom row is going to illuminate. I'm sorry,
so
the top
smart.
Row is going to illuminate. Depending on the lid, the different row will illuminate. So
it
you know exactly
what lid,
knows exactly
is,
what
on
lid
there.
Is on it.
Okay, again, brilliant.
And here we're gonna choose pressure, high, and we're actually just gonna go up for 1 minute or down to 1 minute. And that's all it's gonna take after it builds pressure to cook that steak and to cook those potatoes.
Wait. Say that again.
1 minute after you build pressure to actually cook that steak and cook those potatoes.
That was rock hard frozen.
That was rock hard frozen.
So it reaches pressure. It knows when it reaches pressure.
Knows when it reaches pressure. That little circulating, I call it a snake on the UI, will turn off and it will start to count down as soon as it reaches pressure. And for however many minutes you set, we set one. And then once the 1 minute is over, it'll ding and you're gonna come back and switch the lid.
Get out of here.
Yep.
So then we're gonna use the air fryer just to get it browned and caramelize the steaks.
Exactly.
Oh, I love
so
this.
What I did in this unit is I actually swapped my lids or swapped my tops, if you will.
Okay.
And I mashed my potatoes and added a little bit of cheese and cream because everything is better with cheese and cream and butter. and then I added some veggies to the top. So here, what we have.
Oh my gosh.
Did you see that? So in just minutes, we transformed something from frozen to a fully cooked steak dinner.
That's crazy.
And here I'm gonna add a little bit of asparagus to each plate, and you're gonna have your tender, steamed, roasted asparagus, your perfectly cooked steak, and underneath of the steak, this is like possibly my favorite part, we are going to have a crispy, mashed potato, cheesy mashed potato. What do you think?
Fork ready. Like,
you want to just dig right in?
No. Okay. I'll at least be polite enough to wait till it's the
plate.
Here
we have those creamy, cheesy
mashed potatoes. That's insane. Okay.
All in about 30 minutes.
You got ooey gooey super sticky. How's cleanup? Because that's the next question you're all asking.
That's the next question. So actually, just even looking at these mashed potatoes, I can move them around the inside of the pot. This is a dishwasher safe, non-stick pot. So when you're done cleaning up, you're just gonna take everything out if you have any leftovers, which you might not because it's all delicious.
Not my house.
And then you're just gonna pop it right in the dishwasher. So one pot to clean, dishwasher safe, and you don't even have to do any work here because you're just gonna pop it in and your meal's done. You've fed the family and there you go.
Oh, that's insane. That was so good. And it's hot.
And I'm just gonna actually cut into this steak and show you how well it's cooked.
That's beautiful. Whoops. And while you're doing that too, yep. I just want to repeat what these all do because I think it does so much. Mm-hmm. And I think it's important to understand just how versatile it is, and then we'll go to the phones. In pressure cook, mm-hmm. steam, slow cook, sear, saute. Mm-hmm. In air, it air crisps, it's gonna bake, roast, broil, and dehydrate. Mm-hmm. We're the only unit that actually have added the dehydration. So if you ever wanted to do dehydrated fruits,
yep.
or you're doing jerky, I hear the jerky is exceptional, yep. which I'm gonna try that too. It actually dehydrates. And again, that's so important to realize. There's another place that had this. It was $20 more. It sold out, didn't have the dehydration. We have the dehydrator included in this one. That's a big differentiation. And we have the best price anywhere in the whole wide world. Update for you, we're gonna hit 3,000 sold in just this first airing in just a minute. In the white or the turquoise, if those are your two choices, I'm sorry, the aqua, we're less than 300. We're at about 290 in the aqua. In the white, we started with 400. I have just a little over 300 left in the white. So the chances of those selling out are, I think the whole thing is gonna sell out. But those two, if you want either one of those colors, I wouldn't go to sleep tonight without it. Let's go to the phones. Hi, you're on the air. Welcome to HSN. What's your name and where you're from?
I'm Felicia, Ohio.
Well, hello, another Buckeye. Yay, I love a Buckeye.
Hi,
Miss Felicia, meet Kenzie.
Hi, Kenzie.
Hi, thank you for calling.
You're welcome.
So what do you think?
Oh, this is fantastic. I've been waiting and waiting and waiting for this.
Why have you been waiting for it?
Because I can get rid of put my pressure cooker away mm-hmm. and my air fryer away in just one pot.
Isn't that awesome? And you know, it also does so many other things, like rice.
Yep.
Yeah. Awesome. Are you familiar with the Ninja name?
Yes, I am. I have several Ninja products.
Oh, very good.
Thank
so you know
you.
The quality. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, you're going to go nuts with this, Felicia. Have fun.
Well, thank you.
You too. Have a great evening.
Okay, you too, both of you.
Thanks, Felicia.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
By the way, the jerky is fabulous. I just ate a bite while we were talking to Felicia. All right, what do you want to do next?
Yeah, so I'd love to talk you through the dehydrate feature. This is, like you said, what we are showcasing today, which hasn't been available, and people are excited about dehydrating. Mm-hmm. I am so impressed with how savvy everybody is and what they're planning to dehydrate. So I actually asked, what do people want to see when I come on air today? And they said, I want to see what that dehydrator does. So here we've got an array of all the different things that the dehydrator does. You can dehydrate jerky, which you're eating and loving.
It's so delicious. And it's not super dry and doesn't taste like leather. Because mm-hmm. I know some jerky, and this is really good jerky.
Then we've also got some dehydrated citrus. That's going to be great for garnish as well. We've got dehydrated apples. What a great treat to give the kids for a snack at school. Dehydrated tomatoes, dehydrated strawberries. The options are really endless. And throughout the cookbooks, both the cookbook that gets packed into the unit as well as my cookbook, we've included a ton of charts in the back. Everything to help you get started, including a dehydrate chart and an air crisp chart. So everything's going to be right in there. So no matter what you want to try dehydrating, take a peek in the back of the book and it's going to teach you how to do that.
Yeah. And I want you to think, do you have a steamer? Do you have a fryer? Mm-hmm. Do you have an air fryer? Or a traditional fryer? Do you have an air fryer? Do you mm-hmm. have a pressure cooker? Do you not have any of those? I went online just because I'm a geek and I love it. And I went online and I said, all right, let me just look up a pressure cooker from HSN. And we have a lot of great names, but just a pressure cooker. Mm-hmm. And when I looked it up, I found a price on our pressure cooker. One of them is $140. Wow. Okay, so there we are. Then I looked up an air fryer. We have an air fryer that's a customer pick mm-hmm. online right now that's almost, I had to double check, $300.
Wow.
So just for those two appliances, how much room do they take? How cumbersome is it pulling them out, putting them away? Do you use them very often? I think when you combine it all into one great appliance, that's when you get the biggest bang for your buck. Mm-hmm. You know, because you're using it every day. Maybe it's reheating pizza. Great. Maybe it's you're cooking something like a mac and cheese. Great. Maybe you're trying to eat less fried food, but you miss that taste of fried. Mm-hmm. It's going to do that for you in the air frying system. There's not another appliance out there that does what this Ninja does. And that's why they can't keep them in the stores. They can't keep them online. They can't keep them on television either. And we were thrilled. We actually heard people were kind of crabbing that we got this today's special because we have such an awesome, awesome value tonight. And this is the only place you're going to find this value. Mm-hmm. You've got to compare apples to apples. This unit for HSN and for you does more than any of the other Ninja units that are out there. Mm-hmm. I think that's crucial to understand of why you want it tonight. And we're doing it at the best price anywhere. So we have the best deal going with all the racks that you get with it, everything included, including the cookbook to get you started. And yeah. I would highly recommend grabbing Kenzie's book because it's awesome.
Thank
Kenzie,
you.
We want to just show the chickens real quick how started. And then we're going to open up some more things. So explain what we see on the right to the left.
Yeah. So here you're seeing a pressure cooked chicken on your left. And that's what you get when you use a pressure cooker or when you pressure cook in our unit. That's great for things like soups and stews, but probably not what you're going to present to the family when you're serving dinner. The tender crisp chicken is on the right, and that is going to be golden brown and delicious. That skin is nice and crispy, and the inside is going to be nice and tender. That's the perfect, like, rotisserie-style chicken for the weeknight meals. You're going to love it.
Oh, Francine says, ah, now it has the dehydration in this one. Yay, Francine. And she says, I'm going to get another one because it has the dehydrator, which the other ones haven't had. All right, well, oh, here we go.
So we had to come back to this pasta that we built a few minutes ago. I kind of forgot we built it, but I want to show you exactly what this means when you use the crisping lid with your One Pot Wonders. You're going to get that super cheesy, ooey gooey topping that really is the hero of any casserole. Mm. Look at that, nice and steamy, ooey gooey and crispy. And because we added that pepperoni right on top, those pepperonis are going to be super, super crispy.
They're crispy. See that pepperoni right there? It's got that yummy crisp. Now explain how you started this.
Yes, so we started it from a dry box of pasta.
Thank you.
Juggling right now. So we started with a dry box of pasta, no boiling needed, just popped it right into the pot along with our pasta sauce, and we cooked that pasta right in the sauce, again, from just a raw box of pasta under pressure.
Okay.
Then, after about 2 minutes, we switched.
So wait, raw pasta done in 2 minutes. That's the beauty of pressure cooking.
Mm-hmm. Okay. 2 minutes after you build that pressure, and we switched the lid, and this is the part that you saw. You saw me add the extra cheese on top, and then I switched the lid and I crisped for about 5 minutes, I think, total.
That's crazy.
And look what you get. You get that crispy topping and that pasta underneath.
So good. It's so good. Yeah, we want to have another reveal too, but yeah, let's talk about how you do
switch
lids.
Yeah, so I really wanted to show you how simple this is. I cooked the pasta under pressure, and that's simply using our pressure lid. You're gonna choose whether you wanna vent or seal right here using this knob. When you're pressure cooking, you always wanna be in the sealed position, and you switch that to vent for releasing the steam. Then, once you're done, you're gonna take that lid off, and you're going to add your cheese or maybe just oil up your chicken, and then you're going to pop your crisping lid right down, and that's going to allow you to crisp. So super simple, just swap that top, and it unlocks so many possibilities.
Look, I grabbed a pepperoni, I gotta eat this one, sorry. Oh my gosh, you guys, you know what? Here's the thing. Well, here's the thing.
It is.
Sorry, I'm finishing the pepperoni before I was gonna talk.
So there,
but here's the thing. No, this is what's really crucial about this is, this is going to take up so much little space compared to all the other appliances you have. Give them away, donate them, pass them off to your kids, whatever. This is the one you need. And if you don't have a lot of appliances, honestly, I wouldn't buy anything but this. Mm-hmm. I really would. And I've done a ton of pressure cookers. I've been doing a lot of air fryers over the years. Guys, I've never, ever had an experience like this one. And you know what I did? I just decided I was gonna do guilt-free fried chicken. And I gotta tell you, the interior was so juicy and so delicious. Mm-hmm. And the exterior tasted just like fried chicken. It was so authentic. And that was just on the air frying mode. And you know what? I've used an air fryer almost every day of my life. I have it sitting on my counter. I have another brand. And I thought, what are they gonna do with air frying that's gonna make it that different? No, seriously, because I'm a consumer.
Yeah.
I'm as guilty of I question everything, right? And I thought it couldn't taste better. They're just air fryers. Even the air frying difference was dramatic compared to the one I had sitting right beside it on my counter.
You know what else is amazing about this air fryer is this crisping lid. So now you actually are able to clean your air fryer. That's something that you can't do with traditional air fryers unless you tip them upside down and you get all in there. I dare you to go look at your air fryer at home. I promise it's not pretty.
Yep.
But here we're actually showing you exactly what's happening. And this again is a non-stick underneath of that lid where the fan is. And you're gonna be able to actually go ahead and wipe that down in between uses.
That's great.
Now what actually unlocks all of that air fry performance is the air fry cook and crisp basket. And that's what I'm using right now to do 2 pounds of crispy chicken wings. So I did this from frozen to super crispy using my tender crisp feature. I lost a little chicken wing there. And look how crispy golden brown those are. That looks delicious.
Now, was this just on air fry?
That was just on air fry.
Okay, gosh, look at
that. I'm sorry, no, from frozen, I did that pressure first and then crisp. But if you were just doing chicken wings, you'd do them on air fry only.
Okay, so how long did it take from frozen?
Just under 30 minutes.
Come on, get out of here. And then do you finish it off with the air fryer?
And then we finished it off with the air fryer.
Look at that, you guys.
Look at that.
Oh, and again, that's gonna, here's what's really cool. Because of the pressure, you're getting a much better taste, a much better flavor. Mm-hmm. It's more moist, but you don't miss any of the fried because that air crisping gives you that fried effect with zero of the guilt. Yeah, that's an amazing meal to serve. And by the way, if you love those chicken wings, it's from Coach Joe. There's 5 pounds. They're called jumbo wings.
Ah.
We've got them available, and they're even on auto ship. Trust me, I would love to eat that right now because they look so good. But hey, if you love chicken wings, this, along with Coach Joe's wings, you are in. Now, what'd you do here?
So now, I showed you a lot of different meats that you can cook, but I love air crisping veggies as well. And these are my air crisp Brussels sprouts.
Oh my gosh, they are going
to be super, crispy and delicious, and they are flying everywhere because we did so many in this cook and crisp basket. Just look at that, overflowing. And that's, again, that cook and crisp basket is unlocking that ability to crisp on the outside, and it's able to get through all of the nooks and crannies no matter what you put in it.
And yeah, what's this?
That's a little sriracha mayo just to go on top.
Yes, please.
There you go.
Let's see if I got it. I got the old gourmet. I'm doing the schmear, right?
Beautiful.
All right, so here's what I'm gonna do, Kenzie. I'm gonna come back and join you again.
Great.
Guys, I'm gonna go over here and I just wanna give you some updates and what you get in our configuration. By the way, not only do you get the cheat sheet that's included, when you open the box, this is it, and it gets you started right away. It only took me 5 minutes. I was in and cooking within 5 minutes of getting it. It's just that easy. And understand, even when you go under pressure, that's easy to do. You never lose, there you go, or misplace the other lid. You don't need more storage space because the lids aren't separate. It's attached to the air fryer, and then you're gonna put the pressure lid on when you need to use it. That's that flexibility and that versatility they built into this. So here's the black, obviously huge favorite, great gift giving. If you've got anybody getting married and you want to start off that marriage right, if they want to cook great in the kitchen with delicious food with very little effort and really short on time, get them the black because that's going to match every kitchen. The white I think is gorgeous. I want you guys to see, and I complimented the gang from Ninja, this is the venting system on top. It's beautiful. Like, it's beautiful. It was amazing. Yeah, there's no stone left unturned on how well this is made. Look at how, that's the vent. Now, they could have just made something kind of ugly and grill-like and whatever, but they even thought about making this just a beautiful experience because you know what? You don't put this one away. This is the one you show off and you leave out on your counter. So everything is gorgeous. You know what I love too? Kenzie, wherever you went, we didn't talk about? Wait, the double handles. There's two handles on both sides, so when you pick it up, you're not trying to grab it like this and kind of wrestle it. There's handles on each side. Do you see that? Right there and right there that make it really easy because you'll feel this is built durable and it's built beautifully. I was calling it in my head kind of the Rolls Royce of pressure cooker air fryers because it's just so gorgeous and I love those handles. We didn't talk about that. It's a great feature. All right, very limited. The turquoise. This one is really, it's called aqua. Sorry, I keep calling it turquoise. It's aqua. I have 190 left. Now, if you want the aqua, let's have a little moment here. Little Suzanne Runyon. Hi, you're watching HSN Moment. get the aqua tonight. Don't you dare wait on the aqua, because that's not going to be around very long. The one I got to try was the cinnamon. I think it's beautiful. It looks great in any kitchen. Now, you're going to get instructions. You get the quick start guide. That's all I use with the quick start guide to make my fried chicken tonight. That's all I use. You get, that's the crisper. You get double racks that actually are reversible, and that really helps you do layers of food, so it's that one pot wonder everybody's talking about. You get this. This is great. This is the pot that you put in, and then you're going to put all your racks and everything inside that. This is the recipe book that comes with it. There are 45 awesome recipes. I love this book. It really shows you how to do either or and both together. And I would recommend, even though I don't have it in my hand right now, Kenzie's book really just takes you to that next level. All of it available, lowest price anywhere. And this unit specifically for those of you shopping with us does more than any other Ninja that's out there. This is now also a dehydration system. So if you want to make the jerkies, if you've always, I've always wanted to dehydrate things, but I wasn't going to buy a big, huge unit just to do that. It's also a rice cooker. It's going to cook your beans under pressure in minutes. It's going to make making that homemade food fast, but even better than ever before.
Super fast. So that's what you just saw in that animation, is the pressure going into your food. That's going to keep it nice and moist, and it's going to cook faster than the traditional way you cook. When I cook a chicken now, I can do it in under 30 minutes. In your oven, that takes a lot longer. Now you see that crisping lid going to work. It's pumping that air around your food. Every nook and cranny is gonna get super crispy and crunchy and delicious. And I'd actually love to walk you through exactly how we do that chicken, because it's probably the best example of tender crisp technology. That's our way of saying pressure and crisp, tender crisp technology that we have. So here you have that crisping lid. And you were just saying, Suzanne, Ninja thinks of everything. We don't leave any stone unturned. We even think through how you're going to actually clean every piece of your appliance. Oh, so that little piece on the bottom of your Cook and Crisp basket is going to come apart for easy cleaning, and this whole thing is going to be dishwasher safe as well. So all of those appliances, all of the racks, they're all dishwasher safe along with that cooking pot.
Including the cooking pot.
Including that cooking pot.
Yeah.
So now what I'm gonna do is take a 5-pound chicken and place it right into that Cook and Crisp basket. I trust the chicken first. That's just a fancy word for tying it up. Before I put it into the pot, I'm gonna go ahead and add my liquid, about a half a cup to a cup. This is chicken broth. You can use water or wine. I say use broth or wine because it's gonna add much more flavor to whatever you're cooking. Now we're gonna add the aromatics. Aromatics, again, fancy word. All it means are herbs and spices. So we're adding some lemons, some garlic, some rosemary, and some peppercorns right in there. And then we're gonna go ahead and put that Cook and Crisp basket with our chicken right on top and nestle it right in. Now that we have our Cook and Crisp basket inside, you're gonna go ahead and add that pressure cooking lid. So that's one of the two lids that come with your unit.
And you don't remove the other lid. That to me was so smart too. It's like I don't have to figure out what to do with the other lid.
Exactly, that other lid stays attached, and we did that for your convenience. So it's always there to just pop down and crisp. Okay. That pressure cooking lid is gonna be something you take away to clean. You're not gonna wanna put this in the dishwasher though, just use a wet cloth to clean that. Okay. Now we're going to add our pressure cooking lid. You're simply gonna assemble it and twist, and then right in front you'll see I'm gonna go ahead and choose pressure, and I'm gonna do that for on high for 20 minutes. So this is a little longer than some of the other recipes we showed you. We're gonna do 20 minutes under pressure. As soon as I click start, that snake starts appearing. That's telling you that it's building pressure. You'll also see the blue light illuminated. That means that your pressure cooker lid is on. We're trying to teach you every step of the way exactly what's happening.
And tell them, it's so smart, it knows which lid you have on.
It knows exactly what lid you have on. So when you install the pressure cooking lid, that top row is going to illuminate for pressure cooking, slow cooking, steaming.
Like, isn't that kind of, you don't have to figure it out. The thing goes, oh, you put the pressure lid on. So just look at this row. Mm-hmm. Hello, don't look at the row below because it's not lit up. It's automatic. I just think that is so
smart.
Every
single piece we think through so that you don't have to worry about it. The product, the Ninja Foodie, is going to do all the thinking for you so that you don't have to worry about it and you can go take care of other things. Right. Help the kids with homework. Help, you know, clean the house, or you probably are cleaning the house. Have the kids clean the house and you go have a glass of wine.
Good idea.
now I'm gonna show you what happens when you're done pressure cooking. So after the pressure's built, it automatically switches to the countdown and then it's done. You're gonna release pressure using this vent right on top and switch it to the vent position. And then you're gonna remove that pressure cooking lid. And here we have that steamy, tender chicken. You could stop here if you're just making a soup or a stew and break that down. What I wanna do is turn this into the perfect like rotisserie style chicken. So what we're gonna do is add a little bit of oil and you're just gonna brush that on top. My other secret here, when you're cooking a big roast or even if you just wanna make your life a little simpler, just use the spray oil. It's gonna be super simple and super quick.
Nice idea.
Now I'm gonna add a little bit of salt and pepper. The higher you go, the more even it is. Get a little bit around the whole top of the chicken here. And then we're going to go ahead and lower that crisping lid. So super simple, swap that top. And we're now going to go ahead and choose our air crisp function. So we're gonna choose air crisp.
And you notice it lit up, so it told it.
It lit up. And here you can change your temp and your time. We're actually gonna keep it at 390, but we're gonna go ahead and change our time down to just 15 minutes.
That's great. And let me ask you, what are the temperature ranges?
Yeah, so this is actually gonna go all the way down from about 100 degrees for your dehydrating all the way up to 450 degrees for broiling.
That's amazing. And again, remember, it's a broiler. It's also, it's sears. The darn thing sears. So if you need to sear some meat to get it started before you're actually gonna cook it, you imagine searing it, putting it under pressure, and having a big roast done in how many minutes?
I mean, 30, 40 minutes tops.
Crazy. And it'll be some of the most delicious food you've ever eaten in your entire life is under pressure. What I love too about being under pressure is from frozen, you can get the meal out to the family in literally minutes without having to go through the drive-thru, order the pizza, and have all the guilt associated with that. Mm-hmm. You can make some of the most delicious, what tastes like mom did it for hours on the stove on a yes. Sunday meals, and you're doing it just like that. And now that you can add the air frying element to it to give it that caramelization or that crispness, that just, it sends you to the moon. I can't wait. I totally get why they cannot keep this in the stores. I get it. It's really a revolution in cooking.
It's gonna change the way you cook. You're gonna feel good about the food that you're feeding your family because you're gonna be able to put a full meal on the table in under an hour easy, under 30 minutes. Here, that's that final roast chicken that we saw earlier.
15 minutes later.
Exactly, about 15 minutes later. Now, just listen to this because I'm just gonna run my knife around the top. I want you to hear how crispy this is. You can literally hear it. That's that crispy skin, and I'm gonna go ahead and just dive right in and show you how moist it is, because you're just going to be able, that you can hear that crispness as I cut into it. Every single piece is going to be nice and moist. It's gonna be tender crisp.
And
crispy
can I
on the
something?
Outside, tender on the inside.
Can I say something I did too?
Yeah.
On my piece of fried chicken that we keep showing, my non-guilt fried chicken, here's what I did. I put it on the rack, because have you ever done a baked chicken in the oven?
Mm-hmm.
And immediately what happens is the bottom side of the chicken is gunky and it's greasy and it's nasty and you don't eat the bottom side because it's so gross. So I figured, wait a minute, air frying, I've never used a rack before because my air fryer doesn't have it.
Mm-hmm.
I put the rack in, I put my chicken on it, and guess what? The bottom
doesn't get soggy.
So it was so delicious. And I did. I'm such a nerd, I tapped on the top and then I flipped it over and I said, logically, it should be crispy. And I did, and it was as crispy on the bottom as the top, and it tastes just like delicious fried chicken with zero of the guilt. Because you just use a little bit of oil or a little bit of butter, whatever you want to do. But the rack really makes a difference, and you can really tell that vortex of air, how it's really circulating all around whatever
all
you're cooking.
All around everything, and that's why it's redesigned an air fryer in this shape you can't find. That's because we're getting that 360 air everywhere. Whether you're using the rack or that basket, you're gonna get crispy results. And again, that rack also flips, so it's got different orientations. You can use it in the taller rack position, which you just had, or you slip it right upside down, and that's how you're gonna do things like steam. You could also fit a cake pan in there, or a loaf pan to make your banana bread, and use this as your oven, especially in the summertime when you don't wanna turn on your full-size oven.
And stuff's not sitting in its own oils and gunk, so it turns out great. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do.
Okay.
I'm excited because Shannon has her own show coming up today, but this might not be in that show. Sorry, Shannon, because I know she's probably watching, but it's going to be a great show. She's one of my dear friends. I love her to death, and I'm so excited. So what's going to happen is later on today, we have a lot of exciting premieres, including Marlo actually will have one at 5 o'clock, and then Shannon's going to have a great cooking show. In fact, Marlo's is called Good Eating, and Shannon's is called Your Kitchen. Your Kitchen with Shannon, and that's at 8 p.m. I know it all looks delicious. Let's take a peek at what's happening tonight.
If you've watched me at all over the last 20 years, you probably expect the unexpected. What you might not know is I also love to cook. I'm going to take you on a little glimpse with tips and tools that you can use in your kitchen as well. Monday nights at 8.
And it's going to be such a fun show, and I know she's so excited about it. Kenzie's with me from Ninja, blogger, author, a fabulous cook, obviously. And I do want to mention she did an accessory book to go back to this. You had a lot of fun with this.
I did.
It's the complete cookbook for beginners, because this is under a weird technology. You might not know about pressure cooking, and it's one of the greatest ways to cook. You'll learn it. You might not know about air frying. It's also one of the greatest ways to cook. You'll learn it. But she teaches you how to combine them both for the ultimate in flavor, in taste, in great meals that are done so fast for you and your family. Now, let me do a little update on colors. If you want the aqua, I have 100 left. Okay, the aqua's not gonna make it past the launch, so the aqua's almost gone. Then the next most limited is gonna be the white, okay? So aqua will sell out in the next 20 minutes, okay? I have 300 left of the white.
Wow.
That's it. Now, the two most popular colors are the cinnamon and the black, and that makes sense. But if you want that aqua or you want the white, I will guarantee you the aqua will not make it past this show. Just wanted to give you a little heads up because you'll be really upset. Yeah, you'll be really upset because you're like, oh, I wanted the aqua. And then it's like, oh, not here. Okay, let's keep cooking. What do you have here?
Yeah, so next, in that beautiful cinnamon color that you had home, we are making a chili casserole. So, like you said, this is going to replace your slow cooker or your pressure cooker. Whether you like to cook something slow over time and make your chili that way, great. If you like to pressure cook your chili and use raw beans like we have in front here, you can do that as well.
But some people go, wait a minute, you can pressure cook chili?
Yeah.
They think it's got to be on the stove for 100 hours.
No, because pressure, let me break this down for you. Pressure is going to cook above the boiling temp of water. What that means is you're going to cook up to 70% faster than traditional cooking methods. Oh. So if you want to infuse flavors and tenderize really quickly, pressure is the mode of cooking for you.
And pressure used to be really complicated and hard, not with Ninja.
No.
It's like worry-free pressure cooking. You know, it's not like grandma's stove where that thing was just going like this and you wouldn't ever try it.
No.
This is easy. This what do we have
so
in
what
here?
We've gotten here, after I pressure cooked my chili, I went ahead and I added cornbread right on top along with some cheese. So this is a cornbread chili casserole with cheese, and we put some scallions right on top, and I'm just gonna dig right in. Yum.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
There you go.
Okay, whatever. Woo. And I see a big chocolate chip cookie and ice cream, and trust me, spoon worthy. That looks so good. Wait, can I get a little bite of it?
Yes, please go for it.
And it comes out piping hot, I'll tell you.
Do you want me to get your own?
So this is chili with what?
With cornbread topping.
Oh, get out of here.
So that was just a raw cornbread batter that we poured right on top of our chili, and then we crisped it using the crisping lid. And you're gonna follow regular cooking instructions for that. If you wanted to, you like that?
I'll tell you what, a restaurant can't do that better. That is one of the most delicious chilies
I've ever had.
You go to a competition and win.
Yes, yes. Whether you're going to a smoking competition with those ribs from earlier or a chili competition, you are set. And again, that's one pot. We just use that cooking pot, and it's dishwasher safe at
the end
of the day.
So under pressure. Now think about this. You run home. You're like, I don't know what I'm going to cook. You throw in raw beans, a couple ingredients, pressure cook. They're done in how many minutes?
Depends on what recipe you're following, but less than 30.
Less than 30. You threw a box of
cornbread topping.
Dry.
Well, I mixed it into a batter.
Okay.
Then I pour that right on top. Yep.
Little cheese.
Shut
it down.
Shut it another 15 minutes, and so I'm 45 minutes. There you go. And all of these recipes are going to be in your book, and we actually have a recipe for that cornbread
topping. Are they in this book or in the book that comes with it?
The ones I'm showing now are in the book that comes with it. I want to make sure you get everything you're seeing here today.
And that's 45 recipes that come with it, although we do have the expanded book here. Now, this is interesting because most people don't understand this. It actually can bake.
It can actually bake. So here what we did is we made the chocolate chip skillet cookie from the cookbook. And I'm going to turn that right out for you.
This is the cookbook you're getting.
So you are actually able to bake in addition to making your meals.
And
in
you
addition
just used
to roasting.
A basic old
this is just a pie
foil
tin.
Pan. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just a pie
we'll
tin.
We'll just dig right in.
Oh, sure, yes.
Now, if you were home alone, like me sometimes, you might just eat this all for yourself, but I'm going to serve it and be really fancy for you and give you a nice little slice.
Oh, my gosh, look at that. So, and again, it'll surprise you, all the things. Wouldn't you say it would surprise everybody all the things you can bake in this?
All of the things you can make. In my cookbook, actually, one of my favorite recipes and the recipes I bring into the team all the time are my toaster pastries, tongue twister, strawberry toaster pastries. So these are like, you know, something you might have had when you were a kid growing up.
Yes.
They've got that jam, like strawberry jam inside, flaky pastry outside, and a little icing on top. They're
done
right on the
here.
Back. Yeah, they're right on the back of that book.
And that's in your book.
That's in my book.
So if you want the expanded big book, you can ask that. I'll give you the graphs right now for it so you can order it. Don't miss out. Oh, we've already sold 600 and we're just literally can't get into it. But there's hundreds of pages of really great recipes. Mm-hmm. And all from Kenzie, yeah. And it's $16.99 and she's signed all of them.
I signed them all.
Which I thought was really nice. Mm-hmm. Your hand must be so tired.
It is.
All right, so I'm going to go over this again because if you are channel surfing,